ಕಣ್ಣ ಬಿಟ್ಟ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಕಂಡದ್ದು ಗಿಡಮರ ಬಳ್ಳಿ ಕಣ್ಣ ಬಿಟ್ಟ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಕಂಡದ್ದು ಗಿಡಮರ ಬಳ್ಳಿ ತಿಂದದ್ದು ಜೇನು ಗೆಣಸು ಹುಟ್ಟದ್ದು ಮರದ ತೊಗಟೆ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲೇ ಇದ್ದವು ಆನೆ ಹುಲಿ ಕರಡಿ ಚಿರತೆ ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಜ್ಜಂದಿರೇ ನಮ್ಮಯ ದೇವರು ಕಾಳಿನ ಪರಿವೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಕೂಡಿಡುವ ಬುದ್ಧಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಕಾಡು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೆ ನಮಗೆ ಸಾಕೋ ನಾಡು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದು ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಬೇಕು ಕಾನನ ಕಡಲಿನ ಗುಟ್ಟುಗಳ ತಿಳಿದ ಮುಗ್ಧ ಅಲೆಮಾರಿಗಳು ತಟ್ಟಡವಿಯ ಪೊಟರಗವಿ ಬಿದುರು ಹುಲ್ಲಿನ ಮನೆಗಳು ಹಕ್ಕಿಗಳ ಝೇಂಕಾರ ನೀರಿನ ಕಲಕಲ ಗಿಡ ಮರ ಬೀಸುವ ಗಾಳಿಯೇ ನಮ್ಮಯ ಹಾಡು ಕಣ್ಣ ಬಿಟ್ಟ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಕಂಡದ್ದು ಗಿಡ ಮರ ಬಳ್ಳಿ ಕಡಿದು ಬಿದ್ದಾವೋ ಮರ ಗಿಡ ಬಳ್ಳಿ ಕತ್ತರಿಸಿದರಲ್ಲೋ ಒಕ್ಕಳ ಬಳ್ಳಿ ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಹೇಳೋಣ ನಮ್ಮಯ ಪಾಡು ಸ್ವಚ್ಛಂದ ಬದುಕಿಗೆ ಬಂದಿ ಖಾನೆಯ ಕಡಿವಾಣ ಕಾಡ ನಾಡ ಮಾಡಿ ಬರುಡಾಯಿತು ನಮ್ಮ ಬದುಕು ಇದ್ದೀತೆ ಬೆಳ್ಳಿ ಕಿರಣ ಬದುಕ ನೀಡುವ ಆಶಾ ಕಿರಣ ಇದ್ದೀತೆ ಬೆಳ್ಳಿ ಕಿರಣ ಬದುಕ ನೀಡುವ ಆಶಾ ಕಿರಣ ಈ ಕಾಡ ಕಂದಮ್ಮಗಳು ನಾವೋ ಹಸಿರೊಡಲ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ನಾವು ಈ ಕಾಡ ಕಂದಮ್ಮಗಳು ನಾವೋ ಹಸಿರೊಡಲ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ನಾವು
ಎವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅರ್ತ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಮಿಲಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಇವಾಲ್ವ್ ಹೋಮೋ ಸೇಪಿಯನ್ಸ್ The abundant Mother Nature gave everything. In the process, man has become distinct by walking and talking. This led to vice and misery. Man became selfish. His greediness increased. The virtue of being able to walk and talk resulted in rule over his own kith and kin, including Mother Earth. The wrath of this exploitative attitude resulted in most heinous and inhuman practices that are evident till this day. The innocent Sidamo or Abzi and other tribes of Africa were the most badly affected and victimized people. The Arabs and Europeans, Portuguese in particular, invaded these innocent tribes. They were brutally captured and dumped at Zanzibar Island till they were dispatched from there without knowing the destiny or the future. The tribes were extremely well built. They were strong and hard working, and these qualities made them as saleable commodities. It is estimated that between the 16th and 19th centuries, over 12 million Africans were transported across the Atlantic, most of whom came from West Africa. They came to India 500 years back. Portuguese brought them to Goa. From there, they escaped and ran towards the upper Ghats and came to North Kannada district in Karnataka. Mostly, the Baniyas must have brought them to Gujarat, and Arabs must have sold these well-built warriors with the Nizams of Hyderabad. Therefore, they are found in Karnataka, Gujarat, and Andhra Pradesh in India. The Sidamo of Africa must have been called Siddhis in India. Uttara Kannada district in Karnataka state is fabulously picturesque. The never-ending coastal belt, evergreen thick forest, visible rich resources makes the district very distinct and different. The Hindu Siddhis are not different from Siddhis in general. They are called Hindus since they were slaves under the Hindu masters who were the landlords. The puberty among Hindu Siddhis is not different. Rather, it is a total imposition of high caste values and rituals that they follow. 5 married women will give birth for 5 days to the girl who has attained puberty. On the 5th day, the girl will be decorated with a green sari and other ornaments. The elders declare that the girl has come to maturity that calls for a match. The belief is that the girl is ready to take forward their clan. This occasion is like a festival for Siddhi women. The marriage among the Siddhis is completely influenced by the Hindu rituals. After the engagement and on the previous day of the marriage, applying turmeric paste on the entire body will take place in both bride and groom's place respectively. The basinga will be tied on the forehead and the same will be kept in front of their deity to seek blessings. The groom seeks the blessings of the elders. On the day of the marriage, the bride and groom will stand facing each other. After certain rituals, the cloth is taken out, garland is exchanged. It is significant that no dowry system existed among Siddhis. In fact, there was bride price earlier. They have to give 25 coconuts and 25 kilos of rice for the bride. This may vary according to the capacities of each family. The maternal uncle of the bride takes the little finger and puts them together. Pada Puja is performed by the father-in-law and mother-in-law to the bridegroom. Both the bride and the groom perform Pada Puja of father-in-law and the mother-in-law. The presentation ceremony or Muyi Koduvudu takes place soon after the marriage. Today, friends and relatives present varieties of goods including cash. They take a round of the pendal and the marriage ceremony is over with dining and dancing. Ceremonies for the pregnant woman begin in the 7th month. 5 married women perform the rituals and then the pregnant woman will be sent to her mother's place for delivery. The birth is an important aspect in the lives of tribals. It is a joyous moment since the child represents the continuation of their tribe. On the 4th day after the delivery, the entire house will be cleaned and all the members in the family bathe. They also bathe the newly born baby, which will be laid in a mora that contains rice and coins. The place where the umbilical cord after separating the child will also be cleaned and they worship that place too on this day. This ritual is known as Charavi. That Siddhis still have the genes of their original place is visible in their sense of music and dance. Siddhis are also fond of coconut. and they consider that as very auspicious. The Siddhis do have the concept of their Jamma or the boundary. Normally, when they select a place to establish their hamlet, they worship under a tree, marking that as their area in the forest. During this ritual, animal sacrifice is a must. The elders and the entire members of the community participate in this ritual. Siddhis who came from Goa lived in thick evergreen forest on the Western Ghats. Their harmonious relationship with nature is expressed in many ways. Honey collection is another favorite play for them. They identify the movements of the bees and follow them to the nest. They are so immune to the biting of the bees and use available material for creating smoke to chase the bees. They collect honey from different honeybees. Here, this person is collecting honey from the anthill, which is normally called Thuduve Jeno. Hunting is a foul play for them. They domesticate dogs for this purpose. When a group of young and old decide to go for hunting, first they identify the movement of the game. They go in a group and divide themselves into smaller groups and go in different directions. This is to attack the game from all the corners and reach a common point wherein one person will be waiting to catch the game without miss. The hunted game is shared among all the households in the village. Siddhis have worked in the lands of the landlords. Hence, they are very familiar to agricultural practices. They plow the land and take out the weed. Both men and women work in the field. They had encroached pieces of land that are regularized today. They cultivate paddy during monsoon. Using herbs is a common practice among all the tribes, since they live in remote places. The traditional healer uses different herbs for different diseases. Invoking God is a common practice among all the tribes, and Siddhis are no exception. They invoke God on all occasions. They use wooden plank and rice grains while invoking. The way they dance is amazing. The vigorous steps resemble other African counterparts. The traditional musical instrument called Damami is used for their songs and dances. Death is a loss to the community and their tribe. They consider that the death of a person in the community is a loss to the perpetuation of their tribe. It is painful. The body of the dead is kept outside the hut. With simple rituals, they carry the dead in a typical style. Only two persons carry the body like this. Because of the influence, they bury the dead, and when they are back, the women give them water and also purify them. The third day after the death, there is a simple ceremony of collecting the ashes. On the 12th day, the dead is invoked and all his or her unfulfilled desires will be fulfilled. Today, the rootless, innocent younger Siddhis are going to the school. Though they speak Konkani, the official state language Kannada has become their language.
Amima anuvantaha ekakosha jeevi bhumiya mele kuttu adar nantara ade reetiyagi sumaru varshagalu 1 million varshagalu nantara ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಜೀವಿಗಳು ಹುಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿದ್ದು, ಅದರ ಮೇಲೆ ಸಸ್ಯಗಳು ಹುಟ್ಕೊಂಡ್ವು, ಪ್ರಾಣಿಗಳು ಹುಟ್ಕೊಂಡ್ವು, ಅದರ ನಂತರ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಎನ್ನುವಂತಹ ಪ್ರಾಣಿ ಹುಟ್ಟು. ಆಧುನಿಕ ಮಾನವ ಏನದ ಹುಟ್ಟುಕೊಂಡ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಆಧುನಿಕ ಮಾನವ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿ ಜೀವನವನ್ನ ನಡೆಸಿದ?
ಆಫ್ರಿಕಾ ದೇಶದ ಜಾಂಬೇಸಿಯ ಸರೋವರದಿಂದ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು ಪೋರ್ಚುಗೀಸರು ಮತ್ತು ಅರಬರು ಈ ಭಾರತಕ್ಕೆ ಮತ್ತು ವಿಧ ವಿಧ ದೇಶಗಳಿಗೆ ಗುಲಾಮಗಿರಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ತಂದು ಮಾರಾಟ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಚರಿತ್ರೆ ನಮಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ನಾವು ಬರಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಒಂದೇ ಸಮಾಜದವರು ಇದ್ದಿರಬಹುದು, ಆದರೆ ಭಾರತಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಬಂದ ನಂತರ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂರು ಪಂಗಡಗಳಾಗಿ ವಿಂಗಡಣೆ ಆಗಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಅದು ಒಂದು ಹಿಂದೂ ಮುಸ್ಲಿಂ ಕ್ರಿಶ್ಚಿಯನ್ ಅಂತೇಳಿ, ಆದರೆ ನಮಗೆ ಮೂಲ ಕರೆಯೋದು ಈ ಮೂರು ಜನಾಂಗಕ್ಕೆ ಸಿದ್ಧ ಅಂತೇಳಿ. ಮತ್ತು ಈ ಹಲವಾರು ಜನಾಂಗದ ಕೈ ಕೆಳಗೆ ನಾವು ಗುಲಾಮಗಿರಿಗೆ ಇರೋದರಿಂದ ನಾವು ಹಲವಾರು ಜನಾಂಗದ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಜನಾಂಗದ ಮೂಲ ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಗಳಿದ್ದಾವೆ, ಮೂಲ ಸಂಪ್ರದಾಯಗಳಿದ್ದಾವೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂಟಿಸಿಕೊಂಡು ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂರು ವಿಭಾಗಗಳಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಮೂರು ಧರ್ಮಕ್ಕೆ ಸೇರಲ್ಪಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಆದರೆ ಇತ್ತೀಚೆಗೆ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಸಂಘಟನೆ ಆಗಿ ಆ ಸಂಘಟನೆ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಧರ್ಮ ಯಾವುದೇ ಇರಲಿ, ಆದರೆ ನಾವು ಮೂಲತಃ ಆಫ್ರಿಕಾ ಮೂಲದವರು ಹಾಗೂ ಒಂದೇ ಜನಾಂಗದವರು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಭಾವಿಸಿಕೊಂಡು ಈಗ ನಾವು ಮೂರು ಸಮಾಜದವರು ಸೇರಿ ಒಂದು ಸಂಘಟನೆಯನ್ನು ನಾವು ತಯಾರಿಸಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಆ ಸಂಘಟನೆ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ನಮ್ಮ ಹಕ್ಕಿಗಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ಜೊತೆ ಹೋರಾಟ ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ನಾವು ಬರೇ ಸಿದ್ಧಿ ಜನಾಂಗ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ತೊಗೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಸಂಘಟನೆ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಸರಿಯಾಗಲ್ಲ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಇವಾಗ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆ ನಮಗೆ ಯಾವಾಗ ಸಂಪರ್ಕ ಆಯಿತು, ಆ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಯ ಒಂದು ಅಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದು ಗೌಳಿ, ಸಿದ್ಧಿ, ಹಲಕ್ಕಿ, ಕುಳುಂಬಿ, ಗೊಂಡ ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ಜನಾಂಗ ಸೇರಿ ಒಂದು ಉತ್ತರ ಕನ್ನಡ ಜಿಲ್ಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಜಿಲ್ಲಾ ಬುಡಕಟ್ಟು ಅಭಿವೃದ್ಧಿ ವೇದಿಕೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಸೃಷ್ಟಿ ಮಾಡಿಸಿಕೊಂಡು ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಒಂದು ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶನದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ಗತಿಗೆ ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ಜನಾಂಗ ಸೇರಿ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಪ್ರಮಾಣದ ಒಂದು ಕೂಗುವನ್ನು ಸರ್ಕಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಕೇಳಿಸಿ ಈ ನಮ್ಮಂತೆ ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಆಗದಂಥ ಜನಾಂಗಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಅನ್ಯಾಯ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಆ ಅನ್ಯಾಯವನ್ನು ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಗಣನೆಗೆ ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಂಡು ಎಲ್ಲ ಜನಾಂಗಕ್ಕೂ ಎಷ್ಟು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಹೇಳಿ ಉತ್ತರ ಕನ್ನಡ ಜಿಲ್ಲೆ ಇಡೀ ಒಂದು ಬುಡಕಟ್ಟು ಜಿಲ್ಲೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಘೋಷಣೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಂತೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಹೋರಾಟ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ.
The greediness of man gave way for exploitation. The hunger for power made him to be inhuman. Thus, various forms of slavery, the disparity and discrimination continue till this day. The innocent Sidamo of Africa have nothing today of their own. They have been used by the masters, not even considering their